The history of Houdini and Axis Studios goes way back. 15 years ago, Axis started using Houdini and Mantra for rendering, shading. These days, we use Houdini for many things. We started with effects and lighting. We also do CFX, groom. We also do crowds as well.
We're all really good at Houdini. Houdini is like most of our bread and butter.
It's also the reason I'm here, a lot of the artists as well.
We all just really enjoy working together, and I think between all of us, we're able to make some really cool tools in Houdini to make things look awesome. We work on a varied kind of project, and more recently we've been working on long form projects, and that's where Scrooge, A Christmas Carol comes into it. It's like a psychedelic take on Charles Dickens' classic, and it had lots of different characters. So we took, at the start, we took the main characters and we developed their cloth setup and just took what animation did on it and all the dance sequences and gave it that little bit extra. We use Houdini to begin with to set up the characters. All 56, I think, needed a CFX rig almost that we could use globally across a lot of shots. So we would take in the model alembic and we would break it down to what we needed to simulate, and we would make proxies and just prepare the geometry. And then that would be cached out as like a BGO file so that we can read that into every shot and we can read it into the shot pipeline. And we did that for every single character. Everyone had unique things. So we were trying to work as procedurally as possible. So doing a lot of group selections, creating masks so we could control the cloth more, blend in a little bit of animation later if it was needed, and just refine the shapes that we would get. And then we take that into our shot pipeline, which is where we can add wind, we add all our forces, and that's where vellum really comes in. We've got a cool vellum solver. We took Houdini's native one and added little bits that we needed to. So we added like a wind solver so that we didn't need to use the DOPS network as much. We did thousands of shots, and it's really quick as well, and almost because the characters were so simplified, you could view it in real time when it was simulating, and you could get a lot of iterations. We've got preview tools that we made to make CFX renders so that we didn't need to wait until lighting had lit the shot. We could see it all moving together, all the characters in one shot. And then we have a publishing tool, which allows us to like push out our cloth to lighting. Like we publish out alembics, so it would publish out all of the cloth at once. We don't need to do anything manually. It's great. I love our pipeline.
Scrooge for us in lighting was a challenging project because of the big environment files that we received, and at the same time also the effects. So all the elements, all the assets to build all together, they were the biggest challenge for us, and to be able to work in a smooth way. And Houdini actually was very good and helped us in lighting to manage very big scenes, very heavy, and having very few issues with it. So it was just very, very smooth and it worked perfect for us.
A Man Called Otto is a film starring Tom Hanks. It's about an old guy, very grumpy. We had three broad areas of work. We had a little falling snow, adding snow, lying snow. We also did a sequence with a housing estate, adding a housing estate to the end of the road, and a train sequence. As they were shooting, it would snow, and then the weather changed. So there would be flurries of snow, the wind changed, the sun changed. It was incredible how much that was changing. But being able to match the look of the snow in Houdini, and in terms of its movement, but also having that all in a single lighting environment. We have master scenes set up, and again, Houdini is very good for that, can handle geometry. It's really perfect for those challenges. And then we had different lighting setups, which we could switch out depending on what time of day, whether it was sunny or cloudy. So they were HDRI setups. Where Houdini really gives us an edge is, especially in the visual effects team, we're a fairly small crew, but we can really hit high. And I think that's where the clients really appreciate what we can do. If you say we've got Houdini and we work Houdini, we light Houdini, then it immediately cuts down a whole load of steps in the pipeline. And that, I think, is what people appreciate when they're coming to you. We have to go through this process, then we pass it to this process, then we get to here. They know they're going to take those steps a lot faster. And I think that that's really where it gives us, you know, an edge.
So the groom team axis will be responsible for working on grooming variety of styles. We should start with more stylized projects as Scrooge Christmas Carol, with Scrooge as being a favorite example, the main characters, we worked on his groom and all the variations. If you go in more in-between kind of look, it would be Love, Death and Robot and Maze and Rats being the last one. Maze and Rats, obviously, but also all the rats and all their variations, the dead and the alive one. Then there will be more realistic projects. The last one that comes to my mind is Brothers of War with Agony. It has a fantasy look to it, but the actual picture of the groom still needs to be as realistic as possible. One other aspect in groom that get forgotten about is the look dev. Houdini, because of all the attributes, we can create so much more mixed of data to allow us to get to the look that we actually want to. And with other programs, that's often a bit harder. With Houdini, I know I have fully control of actually every information I want to create. I can be smart about it and create some attributes that I can reuse and change within shader, but also I can create some very specific shaders, attributes that I'll use in the shaders, or actually use custom shaders based on that. So on Axis, we created a shader for creatures, for example, that requires much more mixity, you know, like to create the patterns and stuff like that. And we don't need to have anyone technical about it because everyone on the groom team knows how to use all the tools to create the attributes as they need to for that.
Axis Studios is such a big group of talented people doing so many different styles of projects, everything from feature films, animated features, very stylized game cinematics, more realistic game cinematics. We realized that Houdini as a software really gives us the power and ability to not need developing a new tool set or new softwares to tackle new challenges. When we got approached, can we do this type of crowd? Can we do the crowd that scale? We know we have the software, we know we have the knowledge, let's put in a little bit of time to reassure the project gets delivered. And a lot of the times that's what we face on a day-to-day basis and allow us the flexibility of actually taking new projects. And a lot of our team members really enjoy that. Their day-to-day is not predefined, but what we do, because we actually don't know how the next project is going to look like, what is the next challenge. And from day one that we introduced Houdini into our pipeline, it's always been kind of a liberation rather than a setback. And I think that's really cool.